Samsung shouldn't put out the Z Fold 8 if it doesn't have these two things. I worry that Samsung will be more interested in the trifold and will take a lazy approach to the Z Fold 8. Last week, during its quarterly earnings call, Samsung hinted at a lot of upgrades, including improved CPUs, more AI innovation, and better cameras to keep its shareholders pleased. One of those promises was to pay attention to how well the Z Fold 7 is selling and how well it is being received by the public. There was also a vague commitment to keep coming up with new ideas for the foldable line and provide new experiences. I'm sure Samsung is gently hinting at its impending Z Trifold with its amazing tablet and phone design, but I do hope the temptation of a hot new form factor doesn't let the Korean giant forget about its existing Fold lineup. We are already impressed with the Galaxy Z Fold 7, but it needs two big updates next year. I don't think Samsung should sit back and relax or forego them. Google has already set the standard for all Android phone makers. You can make a phone Qi2 compatible by adding the right magnets. This won't change how thick or heavy the phone is. This year's Pixel 10 Pro Fold is only 0.1 millimeters thicker than last year's Pixel 9 Pro Fold, and only 1 gram heavier. It's such a small, unnoticeable trade-off compared to the extra benefit of having everything you need for Qi2 incorporated into the phone. Samsung can and should take this similar technique with its flagship products next year. If you're paying $2,000 or more on a Z Fold 8 in 2026, you don't want it to be missing a feature that's already available in a Pixel 10 Pro Fold in 2025. That would feel terribly retrograde. If you pay $2,000 for a Z Fold 8 in 2026, you don't want it to miss a feature that's already available on a Pixel 10 Pro Fold in 2025. And yeah, you and I both know that examples with magnets exist, but as I've already argued numerous times, it's not the same thing. For one, everyone gets a broader choice of magnet-compatible cases when the phone itself has magnets. It would no longer be an extra that only a few case brands will offer, but the norm. This would also affect the public view around the phone. A model that becomes magnet-compatible with a hack that a few educated people follow is not the same as one that arrives with the magnets built in out of the box. Companies that create wireless chargers, stands, and other accessories would start selling more products for it, and potentially make customized models solely to meet its foldable form factor. For example, Google has deliberately engineered and weighed the Pixel Snap Charger with stand so that the Pixel 10 Pro Fold can balance on it with the screen open. The Z Fold 8 demands similar attention for its accessories. A basic no-magnet Qi2 ready construction won't push firms to go the extra mile. 2. If Google can do an IP68 rating, so can Samsung. Besides built-in Qi2, Google shifted the goalpost for all foldable this year with another addition. It made the Pixel 10 Pro Fold entirely dust-tight. This is all thanks to the fully hermetic gearless hinge that doesn't allow any solid particles to come inside and harm the phone's open and close mechanism. By comparison, today's Z Fold 7 is just IP48 rated, which indicates its solid protection level can handle particles larger than 1 millimeter. To paint you a picture, Wikipedia presents the example of most wires, slender screws, and large ants for an IP6X rating. Well, gosh, thanks for being safe against an infestation of ants. The Z Fold 7 can only resist solid particles as large as some wires, screws, and insects. Samsung should do better. Samsung can and should increase that IP48 up to an IP68 rating on its next foldable, offering every user extra peace of mind when they take their phones on a hike, to the beach, put it in a lint-filled pocket, or even on grandma's dusty old couch. After all, good dust ingress protection is one of the most critical components of a phone with moving parts, and if Google, with its limited hardware know-how, previously showed that it's achievable, it should be a stroll in the park for Samsung. After 7 generations of foldable, those who buy the Z Fold 8 next year deserve this added peace of mind. They should now be able to use a foldable phone without babying it and paying very close attention to everything it touches and every pocket they slip it in. Over the past few years, we've moaned a lot about Samsung's stagnant innovation and its highly iterative updates, notably with foldable. That's a hot new smartphone category. It's where Samsung should be pushing the boundaries, not recycling hardware over and over again. With the Z Fold 7, Samsung broke its stale pattern and went back to the drawing board with a fresh new design that's thinner, lighter, and so much more useful like a regular smartphone with one hand. Samsung has all the know-how to compete with the other foldables. It shouldn't rest on the Z Fold 7's success. I don't want to see Samsung stagnating again or taking the Z Fold 7's success for granted, iterating on it for another 3 or 4 years without major advancements, all while, you guessed it, putting all resources on the new trifold as if the Z Fold series isn't hot anymore. Adding built-in Qi2 charging and adequately dust-proofing this new design will go a long way to make a sequel worth releasing. More camera enhancements too. Otherwise, we'll all be back next summer, pointing fingers and claiming we're back to the lazy Samsung that only performs the bare minimum. Samsung has all the know-how to develop a Galaxy Z Fold 8 that competes with the other foldable on the market, especially when one of those foldable is a Pixel, made by a business that has no hardware experience relatively. It's like Usain Bolt losing a 100-meter race to me because I just learned out how to tie my laces better. Get cranking, Samsung. The Z Fold 8 is more than just a smartphone. It represents a milestone in the advancement of foldable gadgets. By addressing critical problems and introducing meaningful advancements, Samsung is cementing its leadership in the foldable industry while paving the way for broader adoption of this technology. As competition intensifies and new competitors enter the foldable industry, the Fold 8 sets a high standard for innovation, usefulness, and design. Whether you are a professional seeking a versatile work tool, a tech enthusiast exploring the latest innovations, or a curious consumer intrigued by folding technology, the Z Fold 8 gives a captivating insight into the future of mobile devices. With its enhanced functionality and refined appearance, it promises to make foldable phones a practical and desired alternative for a wider audience. So, if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more exciting tech news and updates. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Goodbye and peace out.